Hello everyone, my name is Shadi and in today's video I'm going to review the first book in the Transfer Power series, which is The Hidden Oracle. So this is the 15th book that we've read till now by Rick Riordan. The first 5 books were from the Percy Jackson series. The next 5 books were from the Heroes of Olympus series, which were like 500 pages long books each. So I think we've already read like 10 books by Rick Riordan if you've been reading along with me through all of these reviews, and I think that's just so crazy. I mean, we've read like 10 whole books in the same universe of the Percy Jackson universe, and now we're on the Trials of Apollo book, which is the first book of the Trials of Apollo series, which is the 11th book, and we have 5 more books left. So in total there will be 15 books from Rick Riordan till now, and there are tons of more to come, I'm sure about that. But actually after the last book of the Trials of Apollo series came out, Rick Riordan has said that he won't be writing any more grand adventure type of books. So yeah, this is gonna be it for the grand adventure quests, but there will be a lot of standalone books and a lot of other books as well. So he has already announced the next book that he's going to be writing, which is called The Daughter of the Deep. I will insert the cover that he posted on Instagram over here, but it's actually not the official cover, which is quite obvious from looking at it. So I'm really excited for that book as well. But let's just get into the review of this book. So this book is about Apollo, who has been thrown down to Earth by his father, who is Zeus. And this has actually happened 2 times before. In the last book of the Heroes of Olympus series, what actually happened was that Apollo did a very bad thing, which was encouraging Octavian. Octavian is one of his Apollo's descendants. Octavian asked Apollo about what to do. He told Apollo that he will make Apollo the most popular god in Rome, and obviously which god would say no to that? He said, yeah, just do whatever you want, and he said that he had Apollo's blessings with him, and that really angered Zeus, because Octavian tried to destroy Camp Half-Blood. Octavian was one of the Roman demigods / legacies, so he tried to destroy Camp Half-Blood, but even he was unsuccessful, but he was very close to doing that, and that was not a good thing at all, and Zeus did not like it. It was not cool at all. So Zeus just turned Apollo into this really weird 16-year-old mortal teenager, and that is the main plot of this book. Apollo has been turned into this really weirdo, and he is, to be honest, he sounds like such an idiot in through all of these books, because he is just so full of himself. He's always like, yo, I'm the best, and all the time he's just like that, and he has always been sending other demigods on quests. He never went on a quest before because, well, he's a god, so he has the power to do whatever he wants, and he has magical powers and etc etc, so he can do whatever he want. And in this book, the first thing that he does is he's just thrown down from Olympus. He's thrown down to Earth from the 600th floor of the Empire State Building, and he just falls down to Earth. He sees that he's in the body of a 16-year-old mortal teenager, and that is when Meg McCaffrey comes into the story. She is just this daughter of Demeter, which you find out later on in this book. She's just this 12-year-old girl who's just like a traffic light. She's wearing very bright colored clothing, and she becomes the master of Apollo in this book. And they first have to reach Percy Jackson's house. Everyone knows who Percy Jackson is because we've been following him through the start of all of these books. If you haven't read the Percy Jackson series, what are you doing? Just you cannot read these books without reading the Percy Jackson books. That is just, I think it's just so impossible, because these books just talk about so many things that you would not know if you haven't read the Heroes of Olympus series and the Percy Jackson series. So that's why I just recommend, or not only recommend, I just say that read the first 2 series before reading this book. and then get to this book, then get to the Trials of Apollo series. So when they reach Percy Jackson's home, Percy Jackson escorts them to Camp Avalad. They have to fight a few plague demons throughout the way, but you know, that's just common with demigods. They just have to keep fighting demons and monsters and stuff like that all the time. So that's not uncommon. When we get to Camp Avalad, we get to find that the words are a little wonky. There is this Grove of Dodona thing in there, and that drives people mad. Apollo and Meg McCaffrey have to go in the woods and just find where the Grove of Verona is and defeat Nero, who later down in this book, spoiler alert, don't listen to what I'm gonna say right now. If you haven't read, I will put the timestamp over here. Skip to that timestamp if you don't wanna know the spoiler. So what turns out was that Nero is Meg McCaffrey's stepfather, which she talks about throughout these books, throughout the first book. She says that her father died years ago. This thing called the Beast has killed her father, and she had a stepfather. She never really told who her stepfather was, because Apollo wouldn't understand who he was anyway, because he doesn't know everyone in the world, because he's not Apollo anymore. He's Lester Papadopoulos, or Papadopoulos, or I don't know how to pronounce that. It's just a really weird name. His name in this book is Lester Papadopoulos or something like that. Lester Papadopoulos or Lester Papadopoulos. I just like to call him Lester Papadopoulos because that's an easy word to say. Throughout this book, Apollo finds out about this group of very evil demigods and Roman emperors from back in the Roman day, back when Roman emperors ruled. That was like 3,000 years ago, and they have actually rised again. So they came into human form when the doors of death were open. They were just the worst of all of the Roman emperors. The first one in this book is Nero, and the second one in the second book is Commodus. Commodus was like the most bloodthirstiest, the worst of all of the emperors that were ever ruled in Rome. So in the first book, in the Hidden Oracle, they have to fight Nero and defeat him. And in the end of this book, Leo comes riding on his bronze dragon, whose name is Festus. So Leo comes to Camp Avalad riding on his dragon named Festus. He's there along with Calypso, who he rescued from her island / prison. It was called Ogygia. So she was imprisoned there from like a very long time, and he rescued her from there and brought her back to the mortal world. And she has actually been turned into a human once she reached Camp Avalad, because she could not stay mortal anymore. She was immortal on her island of Ogygia, but she could not stay immortal all the time. So she gets turned back into a human, and the story continues in the second book. So this book was actually quite different from all of the other books. The ending did not really feel like the same sort of ending that we have been reading about through all of the books, but it was good. I really like this book. I would give it like 4 out of 5 most of the time. With Rick Riordan's books, I give him like a 5 out of 5, but this book was just a little bit different. I hope that the second book is gonna be better. I have read more than half of that book. I'm currently on the second book of the Trials of Apollo series. So yeah, I really enjoyed this book, and there were a lot of jokes throughout the way. That was just a huge part of this book, because he's just being turned into a human, and Apollo is just so full of himself. He's just a really weirdo kind of person. And so yeah, there are a lot of weird situations that he gets himself into. So yeah, I really enjoyed this book. I hope you did too, if you've read it. And if you have not read it, go read it. And yeah, thanks for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. Bye.